Hi friends, today we are going to take up finite verbs, non-finite verbs. We have seen about verbs in the previous video class. Verbs are two types, as we said. One is the main verbs or principal verbs. The other one is anomalous verbs. Main verbs have got conjugation. Conjugation means present form, past participle of the verb forms, principal verb forms. While discussing verbs and tenses, we added one more form to this conjugation, that is a present participle form. It is nothing but ing form. And now we see one more form to this conjugation of verbs, that is infinitives. See that every principal verb has got present form, past form, past participle, present participle, and also infinitives. We are adding infinitives in new form here. When we observe present form, for example, we take one principal verb, write. Write is the present form verb. Wrote is past form. Written is past participle. Writing is present participle. And to write is infinitive form. So we understand infinitive is nothing, just by adding to before the present form verb. So write, to write. In this way, infinitives are formed.
So infinitives are formed just by placing the word to before the present form of verb. For example, to see is infinitive. To write, to run, to sleep, to eat. Okay, like this. These are called infinitives. With another name, we can say even two infinitives. Now, we observe these examples and try to understand. The first one, I write a letter. Write, the main verb is in present form. I wrote a letter. This is wrote in past form. So this is, this sentence is in past tense. And you see, I written a letter. Written is present participle form. Written is present participle form. But we can't make complete sense by the construction. Written is not giving complete meaning like I write a letter, I wrote a letter. Something is missing. There is incomplete meaning. And go for the fourth one. In the fourth one, we find writing present participle verb here. Present participle verb. Here also, I writing a letter, it is somewhat obscure. It is somewhat not understand, somewhat incomplete it is. And the fifth one also, see, there is the verb to write. I to write a letter. It is a finite verb. So we can understand a finite verb. A finite verb is a verb that has a subject. And a finite verb affected by tense, and also it is affected by number. How this is? We see in the examples. See, here it is. He comes from the USA. The principal verb in this sentence is comes. Comes is in present form. So present form verb is always finite verb, as we learnt just before. So this is complete meaning sentence independent. As the subject is singular, the verb is singular. So we have taken comes. There it is affected number of the subject. So subject number and verb number should be same. When singular subject is there, the verb should be singular. And when the subject is plural in number, the verb should be plural in number. That is the agreement of a subject and verb in number. So finite verb is affected with a number. And here you see, they come from the USA. Come is present form verb, finite verb, because it is independent, making complete meaning. And it is in agreement with the subject. They is a plural number subject. So it is taking the verb in plural number. It is in agreement. And here in the third sentence, he came from the USA. Came is a past form verb. Past form verb agrees with the subject, any subject. It agrees with a singular number subject, or the subject when it is in plural number also, past form verb agrees. So this is finite verb. Came is finite, it is affected the number, and it is affected tense. This is suitable, but we should not write like this. He coming from the USA. Coming is present participle verb, but not accompanied with any helping verb. So here coming is non-finite verb. Suppose it is written like this. He is coming from the USA. When helping verb is there, present participle verb becomes finite. But now it is only infinitive, non-finite. And here in the second sentence also, he to come from the USA is wrong, because to infinitive is not independent. It is not affected the tense and number. So this is incomplete. Here we say to come is non-finite. Non-finite. Now we see a non-finite verb. What is its definition? A non-finite verb is that which does not have a subject and it is not affected by tense, number or person. As we have seen in the previous examples, he to see the Taj Mahal. He to see the Taj. It is not making complete sense, because infinitive is used in the sentence. It will not stand itself. It will not take any subject. There is no complete meaning. So this is not in complete meaning, not acceptable sentence. And a verb can be said non-finite. For example, she dancing on the floor. She dancing on the floor. Not making complete sense, because dancing is present participle verb, not making complete sense. Suppose you write, she is dancing on the floor. Now you can understand, it is making complete sense, because present participle verb is taking the support of an auxiliary, is. So without an auxiliary, present participle verb will not affect tense. It will not be affected by tense, number or person. So here it is non-finite verb. So in this way, non-finite verbs are again three types. One is infinitives, second one gerunds, third one participles. Let us see what they are. Infinitives are those which start with to. To say clearly, when a present form verb is preceded to, then it becomes infinitive. For example, to see is infinitive. To drink is infinitive. To come is infinitive. So simply, present form verb is preceded by to, then it becomes infinitive. Let us see this in the examples. See, mangoes are good to eat. Mangoes are good to eat. Here in this sentence, to eat is infinitive. And she went to Hyderabad to see her son. In this sentence, to see is infinitive. So infinitive is non-finite verb. The second one is gerund. Gerund is an ing form verb which acts as noun. Actually, ing form verb is called present participle verb. There, we take it as a verb. But when it comes without any helping verb, and when it acts as noun, then it is called gerund. For example, all ing form verbs, when they function as nouns in sentences, then we say they are gerunds. They can be either in the subjective place, or in the object place. For example, jogging is good for health. Jogging. Actually, jogging has got all the conjugation forms. Jog, jogged, jogged, jogging, jogs, to jog. So like this, it has got a verb forms, conjugation of verb. It is there in that list. But here, ing form verb is used as a noun in the place of a subject. We say jogging is good for health. So So it is acting as a noun, so it is called gerund there. And see in the second sentence, walking is a simple exercise. Walking is a simple exercise because we need not prepare and go for warm up everything. Just simply you can go for a walk like that. So walking is ing form verb here, still it is a serving, it is a functioning as a noun in the sentence. So we say it is a gerund. All gerunds are non-finite verbs. The last one in the non-finite verbs is participles. See, here we have three types of participles. We have already seen two types in the conjugation of verbs: present participle and past participle. Another one is a perfect participle. Let us see what these are. And present participle is ing form verb. All ing form verbs are present participle verbs. For example, seeing the snake, she screamed and ran away. Seeing is ing form verb, but it has no subject, nothing. It is not affected by the tense. It is independent. Seeing the snake, incomplete meaning. It is a phrase. The woman ran away, screamed and ran away. See here, seeing is a participle verb, present participle verb. And in the next example we see, Simla is fascinating. Fascinating is not verb here. Fascinating is ing form verb functioning as adjective, not verb. So fascinating is also present participle verb serving as adjective. So it is a, what is it called? It is a present participle, non-finite verb. And in the third example we see, finding the door locked, the thief entered the house. Finding is ing form verb. It is present participle form of the verb, but no tense, no subject, no number. So it is said to be non-finite verb there. And again we have second type of participle verb, that is past participle verb. All past participle verbs are non-finite verbs. For example, all past participle, it's a beaten, driven, walked, served, eaten, like this. All these past participles, when they are not affected by tense, number, person, they are said to be non-finite verbs. For example, in the examples we find this: walked through the gate, walked through the main door, he entered the hall. Walked through the main door. Walked is the past participle verb. And in the second example, took rest in the afternoon, he worked throughout night. Took rest. Took is a past participle form of the verb. It is not affected any tense, number or person. So it is a non-finite verb there. Last type in the participles is perfect participles. Perfect means there should be have. So past participle verb is added having before it to form the perfect participle. For example, having plus beaten, having beaten. This is perfect participle. Only beaten is past participle, but when past participle is preceded with having, then it becomes a perfect participle. In the same way, having written is a perfect participle. And having seen is a perfect participle. So, perfect participle verbs are also non-finite verbs. They are formed very easily. Just a past participle verb is preceded with having, then it becomes a perfect participle. You see in the examples, having lost all his property, he killed self. Having lost is the perfect participle. If you remove having, lost becomes, it is a past participle. In the second example, you see, having practiced well, he got through the physical test. Having practiced, past participle verb, becoming perfect participle. Like this, all perfect participle verbs also not affected by tense, number and person. These are also called non-finite verbs. Now, we move on to the worksheet to understand in a better way by practicing some more questions. We should identify the non-finite verbs in the following sentences. First one is, I do not have time to enjoy dinner. Here, do have finite verbs. To enjoy is infinitive, that means a non-finite verb. In the second sentence, traveling is my favorite hobby. Here, traveling is present participle verb, but it is not affected with the subject. And moreover, it is in the subject place acting as a noun. So, it is called gerund. In the third sentence, the movie was interesting. Here, interesting is present participle verb, but it is functioning as an adjective. So, here it is also a non-finite verb. In the fourth sentence, it was a beautiful sight to see. Again, to see is infinitive. So, it is a non-finite verb. In the fifth sentence, having finished the task, he felt very free. Having finished, this is a perfect participle because having is there before past participle verb. In this way, we can identify non-finite verbs. Friends, I try to explain the difference between finites and non-finites in the principal verbs. I hope you got some idea over this topic. And in the next video, we try to come up with a new topic. Until then, bye. And thanks for watching this video.